And turn to hymn number 12. Hymn number 12, if you please.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Glory, glory.
Thank
glory.
Jesus, I'm stirred in my soul today. Praise the Lord.
Praise
the
Lord.
He's stirred in me. Thank you.
Oh,
page 571, and the pastor will lead us in the scriptural responsive readings. 571, the page. The first reading, have mercy upon me, O God, according to thy loving kindnesses.
The word of the Lord. Have mercy upon me, O God, according to thy loving kindness.
According unto all truth of thy tender mercies, blot out my transgressions.
Wash me thoroughly from mine iniquity,
and cleanse me from my sin.
For I acknowledge my transgressions,
and my sin is ever before me.
Against thee, thee only, have I sinned and done this evil in thy sight.
That thou mightest be justified when thou speakest, and be clear when thou judgest.
Behold, thou desirest truth in the inward part.
And in the hidden part thou shalt make me to know wisdom.
Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean.
Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow.
Make me to hear joy and gladness,
that the bones which thou hast broken may rejoice.
Hide thy face from my sins,
and blot out all my iniquities.
Create in me a clean heart, O God,
and renew a right spirit.
Cast me not away from thy presence,
and take not thy Holy Spirit from me.
Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation,
and uphold me with thy free spirit.
Then will I teach transgressors thy ways,
and sinners shall be converted unto thee.
Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, thou God of my salvation.
And my tongue shall sing aloud of thy righteousness.
O Lord, open thou my lips,
and my mouth shall show forth thy praise.
For thou desirest not sacrifice, else would I give it.
Thou delightest not in burnt offering.
The sacrifices of God are a broken spirit,
a broken and contrite heart, O God.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world with
come with a pastoral prayer. Thank you. If any of you are tired, you may be seated. If you're not, you may stand.
Psalmist David here was crying out to thee for thy mercy, thy forgiveness, the restoration of thy salvation to his heart, acknowledging that he had failed, that he had sinned. So we know, O God, that as he was honest before thee, you are desiring that all men would be honest before thee in this day in which we live. O Lord, we are thankful for precious ones who want to be all that you want them to be, not once in a while or occasionally or periodically, but continually, steadfastly. Oh, Lord, we pray for your encouragement and uplifting to your people here today. As I look to different ones, it appears maybe that they may have a burden upon their soul. Oh, Lord, we pray, oh, God, that you would work in whatever realm of need they are burdened about, that you would uplift them, that you would encourage them, that you would help them to know that to receive a burden upon their soul is indicative of their walk with thee, and that you can trust them to pray and to cry out to you for whatever need it may be. And we don't have to know the details. You are a God of infinite detail, but you want us to be faithful as little children to cry, Abba, Father.
Thank you.
Lord, we pray that you would help those who couldn't be here today. We know that a few are away visiting loved ones and others are not well. Oh, Lord, we pray that you would help them, encourage them, and touch and give strengthening and renewing to those who are weary, those who are worn, those who have had some infection or affliction come upon them, that you would restore their health, O God. O Lord, we pray that you would work in this community the work of thy kingdom that we know you are wanting to do, for you are wanting men everywhere to come to know thee, to be their hearts clear with thee, and to find the joy, as we were singing about, in walking with thee. Oh God, we know that this is the normal life. This is the intended life. This is the life that you want all men on this earth to experience with thee, to walk with thee and to commune with thee, that you would come into their heart by the Holy Ghost and commune with them and us with thee, oh God. Lord, we pray that you would help this nation. Oh, Lord, there's so many indications on every hand that we are so far, far from thee. Surely only the power of the Holy Ghost drawing upon the hearts of our people would be able to turn us to thee. And as we face soon the selection of someone to be the president of this nation for the next 4 years, oh, God, we pray for your undertaking, your intervening about it, Heavenly Father. That the one that would lead the country aright, maybe his heart's not right with thee right now, but you could make it that way quickly, just as you did some of the kings of Israel long ago. Lord, we want to pray for Israel, for we know, O God, that you see and know the need of thy people descended from Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. That you said you would bring them back into this homeland that you promised to be for Abraham and his descendants through Isaac forever. And that means today. So we pray, O God, that you would help the leaders of Israel to make the right choices and not fear this country or our leaders here or the host of the other nations around them. But look to you, O God, for as in the days of David, Jehoshaphat, Hezekiah, and the other kings, you are able to give them victory today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Laura, would you come and sing the number that's on your heart, please? While she's coming, is there someone that would love Jesus enough to tell us about it? Amen.
I'm so thankful that I can be here. Pastor will pray sometimes for people that aren't able to be here, that they'll be encouraged, and that's how I kind of felt Wednesday night when I couldn't be here. So I was thankful, and I'm thankful. I need to be more thankful. I saw you yesterday, and you were as thankful as you could be about some weeds that you got out of the ditch. And I pray that I can be.
Cut them off.
I have a lot more things to be thankful for than weeds.
Yeah.
And so I just want to praise the Lord that He'll help me be more thankful for things that
praise
I have.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, Joel. My. How thankful we are. Anyone else before she as she comes to sing? And you, yes, praise the Lord.
I just want to praise Jesus and thank Him. I want to thank Him for answered prayer from Wednesday night in my body, how Jesus has helped since I had that prayer. And I want to praise You, Jesus. Thank You, Jesus, that You love to have praise on our lips. Father, help us to be willing to just open our mouth and let the praise out. So we want to come and praise You this morning. Praise You, praise You, praise You, praise You, praise You. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You, Jesus.
Go down and see. Yes, Marjorie.
I just want to praise God for answer to prayer. I've been without hearing in my right ear since the end of May. And I was trusting and praying and had a lot of people praying for me that it would not be a bone conduction loss, that it would be just fluid behind the ear and that I would be able to hear again. And they put a tube in Wednesday, and I praise God that my hearing's back again.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, glory. Thank You, Jesus. Praise the Lord. So thankful. Yes.
I'm so happy. I'm so thankful for Jesus. Thankful for these hymns. I thought, isn't it? It's like a story or like a message. Yes. Seems like I never dreamed hymns would mean that much to me.
Yes.
I was reading this book. It gives background to men and women that wrote the hymns. And Phil Brooks, it was giving, and I've always appreciated this man. I don't know much about him. But one thing that really spoke to me this morning when Paul and I were talking in our devotions, and then I was just thinking about it, and Emery said something about as faithful children. And I thought that they said sometimes they would open this room, and I don't know where he was, and he'd be on the floor playing with the children.
Yes.
I said, oh, Jesus, I know there's a secret in that. We can be childlike because that's where You are, where the broken and the contrite, the humble, that's where He is. So I want to praise the Lord for helping. This week, it has flown. Do your weeks fly? Yes. It seems like we were just in church last week, Tyler. I could hardly believe it.
Yes.
And we had a rich experience. That was a very rich experience for me. Yeah. And I believe for Barbara and Paul. So I'm thankful God is working. He's helping. He's answering prayer. I don't see some of it yet, but I know it's soon. And I thank Him for it. Amen.
Praise the Lord, Marilyn. That's so precious. Yes, Laura. To Israel, back when she was about 15 years of age. And when I told her that she was going, She cried violently with thanksgiving. I mean, with such strength that you would have to see it to believe it. God helped miraculously in giving her the appreciation of what God did. Most every place we stopped, we were still on the buses that time. And every time they got on, she said, oh, I want to thank You for bringing me to Israel. Time after time after time. So we praise God for it. Thank You.
There's a silent war that's raging deep within me. My lower nature fights to dominate. My spirit man is poised and locked in battle. With the carnal side of me, I've grown to hate. The trumpet of my prayers plays towards heaven. A voice of desperation in my cry. Lord, strengthen me that I might not yield myself to sin, but keep Your righteousness banner lifted high. For holiness, and I trust for the righteousness that yours, that my mind would be cleansed and my spirit renewed, and this temple that you dwell in would be pure. The tempter stalks about me as a lion, searching for the slightest sense of blood. For when the skin of my resistance is broken, he moves in swiftly to deepen the cut. The Lord of creation, hear your servant. You understand the weakness of man. I'm counting myself crucified with Jesus, alive to Christ and dead indeed to sin. Lord, I hunger for holiness, and I trust for the righteousness that yours, that my mind would be cleansed and my spirit renewed, and this temple that you dwell in, this temple
Diane, would you come up and have the offertory, please? And would you, David, take charge of the announcements and offertory? Let us stand for a moment just to rest.
Service, I forgot to that I was going to have part of it here in a little bit. Thank you for standing. Do we have any birthdays or anniversaries at this time? Anyone? Oh, yeah, Andrew.
We ever sang to Hollis. His was in August, so I know it was way past and we missed it, but I don't, it's not never too late.
No,
I suppose. I don't think we ever sang to him.
Come right on up, Andrew. You can be seated if you'd like. How old is Hollis now? Is he 94? And Hollis is 93 or 94. And Andrew, he's 24.
Happy birthday to you, and to Jesus be true. May God's riches bless thee.
Got the dollars.
Looky here coming.
Look at these little ones. They're the sweet doll. My. That just done something to me. Oh, mine's in the world.
This is that.
Well, praise the Lord. It looks like we don't have too many announcements. We are using the west side of the church at this time to try to kind of equalize the wear and tear on the carpet. And I want to announce that it'll be next Sunday morning on the 8th is Detention Center Sunday, so please pray for that. Also pray for our weekly special meetings, our prayer meetings for the men at 6 a.m. on Tuesday. And the Thursday, 9:30 a.m. women's prayer. And I'd like to ask you to pray for Sally this morning. She called me a while ago, and she's so deeply involved right now with her play production, with her work, that she's not able to be here. And she was under tremendous burden. The Lord helped me to pray for her for quite a while, and it lifted somewhat. But she's really under a strong spiritual burden, so we just pray for her. Melody will be having a children's church at after we take up the offering, while we'll dismiss the children back to there. Emory and Marilyn will be gone next week, so you might remember to pray for them. They're going to Lake Chapel United Methodist reunion there. I guess they're actually it's not a reunion, it says a sesquicentennial, so they're celebrating their 150th year. 40 years since they were there. So, Lord, just pray for Tyler and I, and that God will help us and come and support us next week. All right, ushers, if you please stand to take up of our tithes and offerings.
Mary,
I think that microphone's got the lights on, so it's gone dead.
Mary is home, but she's not really feeling very good. I appreciate you guys praying Wednesday night. They're not sure if she's passed all the stones, but they went ahead and sent her home, so she might have to go back and forth. I don't know. And Mildred, their grandmother, is out of the hospital now, and she's staying at our house for a little while. And she got a real good report, and they took her off some of the medicine. So she still has a little bit of pain, so you might continue. She has pain come a couple times a day, so you might continue to pray, but God's helping there.
Man, pray for Mary and these, are they kidney stones or gallstones or kidney stones? Let us pray. Blessed Jesus, we thank thee, Father. Oh, okay.
So I asked John to come.
I guess he wants you to play.
To play? I thought you said pray.
Yeah, play. You may pray. Bless your heart.
Jesus, we do thank thee and we praise thee, Father. We pray, Jesus, that you would give us the help and the grace that we need, Jesus. We pray, Father, as we come at this time of tithes and offerings, that you would bless and sanctify it, Father. We pray that you would continue to multiply it. We're thankful, Father, that you have helped us thus far, Jesus. It's been a marvel. It's been miraculous. It's been a miracle, Jesus, that you've blessed this small body of believers. And we pray that you would continue, Jesus, and multiply it back. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you.
Yes, Michael. So thankful that Michael's here. God has given him a wonderful gift of composing beautiful Christian numbers. And we're very fortunate to have God do this, give him this ability, and that we could hear him, because it's very unique and very different and quite precious indeed. Praise the Lord. The children are now dismissed to go to their little service.
I come from the country, I come from the west, I come from the city, I come to prove the test. I come not to judge you, I come to reward. I come in the name of the Lord. I come from the Father, he comes here through me. He comes through his perfect love to prove reality. I come as a prophet and the lover of your soul. I come in the name of the Lord. I come not with a fanfare or sword, except the one that proves I am the Word. I come not to condemn you, but to save. I come to lead the lowly and the brave. Oh, where does he come from? They asked me that, you know. They hadn't read the scriptures. Their hearts were hard and slow. When you count the cost, it'll be all you can afford. I come in the name of the Lord. Well, I came to be holy, that you may be as well. I came that you may come to love and miss the fires of hell. I came not for religion or lukewarm disregard. I come in the name of the Lord. I come not with a fanfare or a sword, except the one that proves I am the Word. I come not to condemn you, but to save. I come to lead the lowly and the brave. I came not to do my will, I came just to obey the things my Father told me, what you must do today. I came not for you to question or look as if you're bored. I come in the name. I come in the name. I come in the name of the Lord.
That the Lord helping.
And see, that was about 1988, I believe.
1988, yes. Like that's a very unusual one. It's very good.
Thank you.
God gives you a certain technique and presentation that just Jesus alone could do that.
That is true.
Yes.
That is true.
And no one else gets that. It's always different when the Holy Ghost gives it like that. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Everybody enjoyed it. Stand up and praise God and clap your hands. This time, you may be seated. Tyler and his sweetheart's going to sing for Jesus. Number 3 on the list. Hallelujah. Praise thee, Jesus. You know, God worked through a voice in the wilderness to get Tyler and his mother and Jeff and come here. Yeah. He didn't know anything about his wife at all. Right. Nothing of her.
That's right.
No. She was raised in a home where her mother was a nice person, but she was a wanderer in alcoholism. It was caught in the jaws of it. She didn't want it, but it took her and just chewed at her life. So this child has had, she's been many times in deep waters and high weeds. So she needs a lot of love and tenderness because of her past. We're grateful that the Lord rescued her and brought her into the kingdom of God. She's unique in her own way. She's very childlike. Has a beautiful high soprano voice. So thankful this morning that Debbie could come because they've been in the play, you know, there at the Civic Theater. And she was able to press out. I called and talked to her this morning. But David and the children are very tired. But would you pray, especially for Sarah? She's not well at all. And she needs a lot of healing because she has this responsibility this afternoon. So we're trusting the greatest thing she ever had.
Hallelujah.
Oh, my, she crowned a prince in Israel. Praise the Lord. He and I have been together. We've been, I tell you, every night it's different. It's a marvel to me. It's a marvel. If I could tell you about it, I wish I could. Only the Holy Ghost could ever convey what happens to us when we get together.
Amen.
I think, how could it be better than this? And next night, I never dreamed of that. The next night, I never dreamed of that. So we praise Him.
Well, I praise the Lord because when Lori was singing, that was all coming to my heart. I've been wanting to testify about that, that Jesus has just helped in just unique and marvelous ways that I don't know quite how to tell, but just in the sharing and the review of the things of the Lord and the things the Lord brings about in the midst of the sharing because of the review. Yeah. And thankful how He strengthened you in Florence. You've been able to be out and around. Don't stop praying. Keep praying. Praise the Lord.
Yes.
And it has been a great privilege to be able to be a part of that with you. But we're thankful if it helps you to get to where God wants you to be.
That's it.
It gets you to others. Yeah. It got you to Lee, the man at the one restaurant there in Muncie, the Country Buffet.
Oh, yes. That was great.
Oh, yes. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
With this black brother and these folks.
That helped you with the manager of the restaurant one time. Yes.
Yeah. The manager came down there and he was all stirred up.
And the young man at the Roberts there, he's helped you there
with that
young man. He remembered you from years back.
Yeah.
And he kept the first dollar you ever gave him.
Oh, yeah.
He kept it.
That's what he said. He said, I remember you.
Yes.
He said, you know, I kept that. I said something about giving him a dollar. He said, well, the one you gave me, I don't know, a year ago, I've never spent it. I've just kept it. Right. So I gave him another one.
Right.
Then I gave him another one.
Right.
So the black brother at the family buffet, I was trying to encourage him, love him. What a warrior.
Yes.
So he came over to our table and he said, I gave what you gave me to that waitress over there. She needs it worse than I do. So I gave him some more.
Right.
You find somebody like that, you don't want them to miss what they're here for because God works through everyone.
Praise the Lord.
So the leader, the manager of this place, reminds me of my doctor.
Yes, yes.
So I gave him all the money I had left for the dishwashers and the cooks.
Split it up between them all.
Split them up, yeah. So he came back.
And he said, oh, no, no. He says, no. He says, I said, well,
don't do that.
I said, I'm not going to be able to go back and give this back to this gentleman because he's not going to take it.
Yes.
So you're just going to have to take it. Praise the Lord.
So
he came back to the table after a while. He stood there and thanked him and shared. And he came back again later.
Yes.
And he had these free passes for.
Yeah, he had eight different little certificates for dinner. And it wouldn't cost anybody anything, and you can just pray and whatever. So the Lord takes care.
Yes.
And God just worked with us and worked with him. And I've forgotten what all happened between me and him. But when he started away, I said, may the Lord take care of these burdens and pressures and heartaches. He said, oh, I hope so. Oh, I hope so.
Right.
He had me right on the trail, and I didn't know him.
Yes. He wasn't put off with you, wasn't offended by you sharing about Jesus.
We were friends.
Right. He was friends. Soaking it in. He was happy about
yes.
it.
Yes. Oh, he was.
He wanted to accommodate it.
He did.
He wanted to do what he could to accommodate it.
I'd like to see him again.
Right.
He said, I'm glad you've been coming here. I said, well, we like to come here.
Right. Just like the person on the telephone, you had to make a call about something, and the person who was helping you, you began to share with them about going to Israel and
yes.
about the Lord, and they received it and received it and received it, and they were going to Egypt for 30 days.
Yes,
and
you and I were on some calls.
That's right.
God revealed to me that he and his sweetheart is to go to his father's mother. She's 90 years old. She wears high heels.
Yeah.
And she's 90 or 91,
drives
the car. And she's a little person, but she's been a great singer.
Yes.
And the Lord revealed to me that the two of these children need to go to his grandmother.
And you've started to pray about when we were to go.
Yes.
And I have my little book out, date book, and you said, not that weekend, the weekend after that. It's the weekend after that.
That's it.
And I said, Reverend Helm, I said, my wife and I just got that weekend off from work.
Oh.
It was the very days that we got off from work because we felt we were needing to do something. And it's our anniversary weekend. Praise the Lord.
Our anniversary weekend. And the Lord, I knew nothing of anything, but our Heavenly Father, Jesus, the Holy Ghost, led again and again.
Amen.
We praise Him.
Yes.
And the Holy Ghost said, get an air pass for them. So
we called this
airplane personnel, and we got into a meeting.
Yes.
And she said,
it almost sounded like she was writing down what you were saying.
Well, I believe so too. She was going to go to Egypt, and the Lord helped me to tell her when to go. She didn't know for sure when to go.
She just knew in January, but didn't have the dates pinned down.
God told me the days that they were to go. We never met before.
Right.
And oh, God.
How many people would receive that just from someone they don't know?
Oh, yeah, I tell you, the Holy Spirit helped in the realm of the precious, the miraculous.
Right.
And I said, how much is it going to cost us to get these children to Providence, Rhode Island, from Indianapolis? That's a long way. That's about 1,000 miles, close to it, maybe a little under. But Providence, you see, it's beyond New York City, isn't it, a little? And New York City is around 700 miles from here. And so we know then that they're to go. And I said, how much is it going to cost? And she said, $217 a piece, round trip. Where in the world could you get such a bargain? Where could you get such a bargain to go from here to Providence, Rhode Island for $217 a piece?
In the past, when I've called, sometimes it's $500,
$550. Boy, it'd be $500 or $600, I thought. It could have been, $400. But the Lord wanted these children to go to be with his grandmother. I said, it may be the last time. She may only be here a little while.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
So pray, because we're trusting for her soul, trusting for...
Yes, trusting for her encouragement, her soul to be lifted, to be ready. And she sings. She's been a great singer in her early days.
She was asked to sing in New York and various places around, but she gave that up for a family life and sang in the churches around Rhode Island and directed some choirs. And
so you see, through her gifts and the gene, it has fallen into your life. And we want to give him praise.
Hallelujah.
For the gift of the voice that he's given you.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
So how the Lord worked with this airport lady.
Amen.
And we have seen some saved in times past give their heart to Jesus when we'd be involved in things like that.
Right. So I was marveling at that because we made another call, and as soon as you just praise the Lord, they were kind of...
Yeah, they were gone.
They were on their way off, and when they put us on hold, I think they may have just left us.
Yeah, they did. They left us immediately. We got her back, she was gone.
So this other woman to receive it, it's just marvelous thing.
She didn't want anything to do with me or what God was telling me to do, and we found that out right quick. So we just skipped on. Amen. Well, now have the song, please.
Thank you, Jesus.
My heart to pray for Sarah, if that's all right.
Please.
Jesus, I just pray that you would help Sarah, Lord. I pray that you would give her the strength that she needs in her body to make it through this day, Lord Jesus. I pray, oh God, that you would help her, Jesus. We don't know how hard she has to work just to live normally. Jesus, probably 4 or 5 times as harder as we have to, Jesus, just to live normal, Jesus. And I pray that you would, Jesus, that you would bring all these things to pass and the promises that you have made for her healing in her body, Jesus, we pray. And we claim it for her today, Jesus. And we pray that you would just give her what she needs. In Jesus' name, amen.
The Lord is my shepherd, I'll walk with him always. He leads me by still waters, I'll walk with him always. The Lord is my shepherd, I'll walk with him always. He leads me by still waters, I'll walk with him always.
The Lord is my shepherd, I'll walk with him always. He leads me by still waters, I'll walk with him always.
The Lord is my shepherd, I'll walk with him always. He leads me by still waters, I'll walk with him always.
The Lord is my shepherd, I'll walk with him always. He leads me by still waters, I'll walk with him always.
It'll be by God's grace. Praise the Lord.
See, when we talked this morning, son, the Lord told me it's number 3 on the left. I didn't know it was going to be that great. Oh, listen. Where are we? What have we listened to here? This is beautiful. If you were in Los Angeles, San Francisco, New York, in a church, you wouldn't hear anything any better. By God's grace, we want to thank him for it. May God be glory and thanksgiving. All right, we're going to be having a treat now with the 6 brothers. We're so thankful Jesus brought them in here. Oh, my. I'm so glad to have Lil here and her son, and how God brought the family down from Michigan. We just want them to know they're loved. And when the meeting's over, get a hold of them and love them and praise God. Thank you, Jesus. These brothers are going to come. Do you have a list? Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Do you have a list? 26. Do you have one on your hearts? 11. Let's stand for a moment and rest.
I heard the Lord help them so much at singing at the church last week. They want them to come back sometime.
Well, of course. They'd want them to come back and stay. But we can't give them up, hardly. No. Number 11.
And Brother Randy was telling me that.
I'm glad you told me. Praise the Lord. So I'm so glad for David Lee. He helps us so much. We're so grateful. Weren't for God working through him, we wouldn't have revival for our day, because he takes care of all the computer work and all the things. He takes care of this and this and this and this and this. We want to thank Jesus.
Marge does a lot.
Yeah, Marge helps her an awful lot. Very much. Amen. You may be seated. So I've been loving them since you were a little fella. I'm trying to love them, maybe not loving them enough.
We need wisdom, we need power, and true love for each other. We have had so many big but empty words. So we come before your face, asking for your grace. bring your king people to a state of kingdom life. Restore your church again.
Touch your people once again with your precious holy hand. We pray, let your kingdom shine upon and the broken, wounded soldiers. Oh, how much we need your precious healing hand. We need the power of the cross as the only source for us. When we stand up facing final battle cry, restore your church again. Touch your people once.
Just 2 or 3 or 5 minutes ago, the Lord said number 11. I felt the Holy Ghost in it. I felt the Holy Ghost in it. We have Jack and Cheryl Hurst with us here this morning. We have them because Jesus told me not to stay at the first motel, the second motel, the third motel, the fourth motel. And when I went up the steps of the fifth motel, Jesus said, this is the place. That's why they're here today. Weren't for that leading, in 1951, they wouldn't be here. I think maybe that's before they were born. 49 years, he's 53, and I didn't think he was that old, David. I thought he was about your age. He doesn't look like 53. He looks like he's only about 47 to me. I had to pray a little bit to find out what that was. And so God helped me to find his grandmother, Gypsy. It's a miracle story. I didn't realize that before I found her, she was having troubles, trials, battles, struggles. She was in heartaches. Hard for them. Plus, I didn't know it until someone told me about it. But when I saw her coming up through the grass, I said, glory. She said, hallelujah. And the meeting was on. Never has ended. God brought her right into what she was trying to find in life. Bruised, wounded, hurt. Because of Jesus' guidance, So we're glad for Jack and Cheryl. See, the first time I saw him about 30 years ago, as soon as I saw Cheryl sitting by his side, Jesus told me about her life, her sufferings, her potential, the gifts, the wounds that she has carried because of circumstances long since began. So we want to praise God that we are able to have them here with us today. We've had great meetings with them. Betty's just like an assistant to them. And it's helped her a lot to have them here because they're like family. We really don't want them to go home, but they got to have bread and butter, so he's got to go back to work. So we're thankful. Jack, would you stand and say whatever on your heart? We talked yesterday a while, and we just talked out of our hearts together. And okay.
Well, it's great to be here. I'm just praising God that we're able to see you and still
a privilege.
Living for God, still serving God, and thankful He's helped you. We prayed a lot for you, and
yes,
we had a great time with you.
We did. We have.
I'm thankful I was able to be with you the other night and
the
meal.
It was wonderful. Two nights.
Oh, it's so great how God helped, and the people felt Jesus' presence. The Lord was there with us so greatly.
Yes.
And I think my wife was so helped and so lifted,
so encouraged.
And I'm thankful for that. I just praise God that we've known you all these years, and we've appreciated everything that we've learned and gained from you. By God's grace, we've tried to live it and tried to love you, and we love all the people that we've met that it's been with you. It's been a blessing just to know Betty and Joe and all these precious people. It's just, I've been so thankful for that, and we can just love people we meet anywhere. It's just, I'm glad that I've been taught this through Brother Helm's ministry, that I can love everyone, whether they're for you or against you, whether they're your enemy or your friend. By God's grace, now it takes the Lord's help. You can just love them anyway.
Surely.
True Christianity.
Sure.
And I'm thankful for this, and I praise God for that.
Pray, would you pray on? Pray now, if you please.
Father, we're so thankful. We just plead the blood over this service, over this day, over all you're trying to do with our hearts. We resist the enemy. We rebuke him and his lies, Lord. We want to see thee in thy greatness and thy glory and how you can work in our hearts if we will obey thee. So, Jesus, I just trust that you'll continue to work with us, lift us up. We truly need your Holy Spirit. We truly need you working in our lives, Jesus. We lift all the burdens that people are carrying here today, God, those that's pressed down and overcome. Jesus, there's so much to be burdened about, so much to pray about. So, Father, we just cry out to thee for the need of the church, for the need of those that's under the weight and the heaviness. Jesus, we lift it all to thee. We know you can carry it. You're able, Jesus. We cast all our cares upon thee this morning. We just give you all of our troubles, all our situations, all our pain, all our hurt, all the suffering, God. We lay it in thy hands, oh God. You're able to handle it, Jesus. We need you so bad each and every day, Jesus, of our lives, Lord. We just trust that you will continue to help, continue to lift. We want to love people. We want you exhibited in our lives, Lord, that others may sense you, feel you, and appreciate your sweetness, your love, your goodness, and your kindness, oh Lord. You've been so good to me. You've blessed me.
Oh,
you've helped me, Jesus, and I give you praise. I give you the thanks, dear God. Oh, we just love each one. We appreciate how you work through all the singers and all the gifts that you stirred up in people. Jesus, it's so wonderful, so marvelous. Oh, that your church could really be the church, could really obey you and be like you in your loveliness and wonder. We thank you again for thy servant. We thank you for the marvelous times that we've had. We thank you for how you've helped him, touched him. Lord, it just seems so great. You know, most people at his age is just kind of withered away or kind of, I don't know how to say it, but we're thankful he still has a sharp mind. He still has clarity. He still, Jesus is in touch with you. And we're thankful for that, how you've helped him, God, dear God. Oh, we give you the glory. Thank you for Sister Helm. We lift her to thee this morning, yes. Jesus. We pray you touch her body. Had such a great time listening to her play the other night, Lord. It just was so heavenly, wonderful. How you strengthened Brother Helm and Tyler to sing, and we all rejoiced and had a great time, dear God, because of your help. Oh, it was sweet. We give you the praise. Strengthen her today, Jesus. Touch her hands. Touch her body. All the joints and all the aches and pains, may they be gone in Jesus' name. May she be strengthened for the glory of God. Oh, give them help, Jesus. Help them know we love them and appreciate them. And we pray you'll help this church, Father. Oh, God, we pray you'll come financially to help them and bless them and bring in the money from the north, south, east, and west. God, you own it all, the cattle of a thousand hills. You're able to supply every need according to your riches in heaven. Lord, we pray that all the hindrances of hell will be stopped and that this place will be released to grow and to gain ground for the kingdom of God. Help them, Jesus, we pray. Lord, in your holy name, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Cheryl, would you testify a little bit, if you please?
Well, I just had such a full feeling while they were singing this last song.
I know it.
And it's what God wants.
That's it.
He wants his church restored.
Yes.
And the only way that we'll be able to do that is on our knees.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The Lord had us timed when her mother died to be there. And he's helped us so remarkably through the years past. We praise him. Amen. Betty, do you have a testimony on your heart?
Yes, I do. I just thank God for his mercy. There's a wideness in God's mercy.
Yes,
I'm thankful today for his mercy to me, for his love to me. Only God knows how much I miss Joe.
Oh, yes.
But it's in the realm of the miraculous how he has helped me.
He surely has.
And I praise him for that today. I thank him for salvation, full and free. I thank him for grace. His grace is sufficient. I thank him for the hope we have because of him.
Yes.
Because he lives, we can face tomorrow.
Oh, yes.
I'm thankful. I'm thankful for all who have prayed for me.
Yes.
Thankful for all the times we've had with you.
Wonderful.
Thanks. I know that my Joe is in heaven today because of your ministry. Because of your faithfulness to God. I know this, and I'm so thankful. How could I ever thank God enough for that? I couldn't.
That's so true.
Thankful for having Jack and Cheryl with me. It's been really a blessing and a help.
Comfort.
And thankful for the times we've had with you this week. They're the highlight, I know, of their trip and of my week. And it's just great because it is the only thing that satisfies every longing of our heart.
Yes, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because he lives. Thank you. Because he lives.
Because he lives.
Jesus went up to Jerusalem. I was always glad when I was a boy to go somewhere. Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Where was he before he started to go up? How do you go someplace? How do you get someplace when you go up? Jesus went up to Jerusalem. There was a terrible day yesterday in Israel. Yeah. Might tell us about it, Tyler.
Emery might be able to tell more than what I know. I don't know if you saw on the news, but they were celebrating, is it Rosh Hashanah? Rosh Hashanah or something like that over there? Rosh Hashanah. Rosh Hashanah. And of course, there's been the tension over whether the Palestinians, you know, they've been threatening to proclaim East Jerusalem their capital again. And of course, the United States has been heavily pressuring Israel for this peace process against, I think, their will. And there was a great outbreak of violence. Did anyone see the news on that yesterday? It was a great outbreak of violence. They said they haven't had it like that in 4 years. It went from rock throwing to the Palestinians pulled out their machine guns as well, and they were shooting at each other, and there were fire bombs, and it was going on all throughout the West Bank. It wasn't one incident. And it's seriously threatened a lot of relations that are going on there. And the comments that the media had some of the Palestinian leaders making, and really didn't give much opportunity for anything to be said, just one comment from the Israeli side. And Arafat, even they got word to him, he was in Egypt, but the people were going to do what they were going to do. They're rioting. They want to be sure that they end up with these areas of Israel that they want. And I don't know enough about it, I guess, to share any more, except that it was great violence going on, and we're in great need of help over there, because it seemed like it was on the verge of sparking a war again, not just some more terrorist attacks.
Quite serious. Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Fifth chapter of St. John's writings, and that's verse 1. Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now at Jerusalem, by the sheep market, is a pool, which is called in the Hebrew tongue Bethesda, having five porches, and here was lying a great multitude of impotent folk. They were blind, they were sick, they were halt, they were withered, and they were there at the pool. Why? Well, they were sick, and they wanted to get well. They wanted to get well. That's why they're there. They didn't go to look at the water. They didn't go to look at the springs. They didn't go to look at someone else who was sick. Every sick person went up there for one reason, and that was to try to get well. Every one of them. I want you to know there wasn't a dozen of them. There wasn't a half a dozen. There wasn't 200 there. It'd have been a big number at a little pool like that. It said a great multitude. Now that's hundreds and thousands of persons gathered around a small pool trying to get well, trying to become strong again, trying to lose their diseases and their sicknesses.
Yes.
See, that's why they were there. They wanted to lose a disease, let it fall off like a shackle. They wanted to get rid of their disease and let it be consumed like the snow before the blazing sun. They came anticipating. Every one of them had anticipation. Every one of them had expectation. Every one of them, hundreds and thousands of them, but only one was healed. And he'd been healed from a terrible thing he'd had for approximately 38 years. You know, when you have something, you've been troubled with it for 5 years and you get rid of it, how happy do you think we are? And you've been troubled with this awful, awful disease, sickness, 10 or 20 years, and suddenly it's just gone, just vanished. Oh, yes. And the one that was healed, well, who was he anyhow? I really don't know. But he made his way there somehow. He didn't get there by himself. Somebody had to make the arrangements. Someone had to look after him. Someone loved him enough to care for him to do this to the limit. He didn't get there just by accident. He didn't get there on his own. He wanted to go, but he couldn't. There's times when you and I want to do something and we can't. We have to have help. Well, he had to have help, and whoever helped him, we want to be thankful for it. Because he got there, and Jesus met his need, said, "Arise, take up thy bed, and walk." And he walked.
Hallelujah.
He hadn't walked for 38 years. Now, if you're in bed, for a dozen days, make it 25. If you're in bed 25 days and you don't even get up, just use a bedpan, you can't walk. You have to learn to walk over again to get your balance. And your feet kind of hurt. Your feet feel funny after all that time not walking. And he walked. 38 years afflicted, 38 years a sick man, 38 years a burden, 38 years walking in anticipation, 38 years walking in sorrow and struggle. And Jesus made him whole in a moment, in a moment, in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye. At the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. Hallelujah. I wish you could sing that. My brothers and I used to sing that. We never heard any group sing it. Perhaps they have, but we hadn't heard anything like it. So he was instantly the sick man. Now he's on a bed. Said he was on a bed. He's on a bed at a pool, and he's healed. When he's healed, he gets up and he takes the bed he was lying on and he carries it. Now it's carried him all these years. Now he's carrying the bed, not because he wanted to, not because he liked to, but because Jesus told him to. Now if Jesus hadn't told him to, he'd still be on the bed.
All right.
If Jesus hadn't told him to, he'd still be on the bed. Are we still on the bed? Are we listening? How much can we hear? Are we hearing Jesus saying, arise and walk? What? Arise and obey. Arise and pray. Arise and lift your burden to the Lord. Arise and be submissive to Him. Arise and know. And He's well. And as soon as He's healed, He's all alone with a multitude of people. There's a whole multitude of people, and he's alone with them. And they said, how come you're walking? This is the Sabbath day, you're carrying your bed. It's not lawful. Here he now is amidst strangers and accusers and buffeters. He's suddenly from Jesus' healing to trouble. He's in trouble. See, he's healed, but he's in trouble. Isn't this wonderful? He can tell me what to do here, and I don't even know how to preach, but he can tell me all these things.
Yeah.
I want to thank him for it. He's healed. He's well. He's carrying his bed, but he's in trouble.
Yeah.
He had a lot of trouble for 38 years. Now he's in another trouble. The other trouble's gone. He's in a new one. He's a new one because the religious people put him in trouble. What are you carrying your bed for? You're not supposed to. And he tried to explain it and didn't know how. In fact, he didn't know so much as how he was healed or who did it. He didn't know who it was that healed him. Jesus had conveyed himself away, a multitude being in the place, and he didn't know who it was that healed him, but he was on trial. The Pharisees, Sadducees put this man on trial and said, you are in danger of being reprimanded here. Here you are walking with your bed on the Lord's day, on the Sabbath day. You're not to do it. So they scold him. Now you take a babe in Christ and scold him, you just about scorched him. You about just squelched him. You about knocked him clear out. So what they had to say almost knocked him all the way out. He got into health. Now he's knocked out to awful, awful straits by the good religious people. Jesus came around to find him, and he found him. And when Jesus came to him, he had a word for him, he had a message for him, he had a startling truth for him. He had a challenge for him, he had a command for him. All those things Jesus had for him. And more.
Yeah.
He looked at him. See, the man that was healed didn't know who he was. He didn't know who it was that healed him. But he's looking at a stranger of Galilee, And Jesus said to him, go and sin no more. He told this man that had been sick for 38 years to not sin anymore. Dr. Stanley, you know, the great preacher, a lot of great preachers say we have to sin a little bit every day. We're likely to sin every little bit every day, and that's true. We're likely to do it if we're disobedient. A lot of great religious people think that you can't live without sinning every day. Did you know that? How many knew it? Yes, they think that we have to sin every day, sometimes. Now, there are religious people that think we cannot sin. It's not possible to sin and be a Christian. Now, Jesus said, go and don't sin anymore. Well, what did that mean to him? What did that mean? What was he going to do to commit sin? Now, you can meditate on that all day, if you like. So here we find the Savior. We find the man that's sick. He's no longer ill. He's carrying his bed. He's well. And here's Jesus telling him, you go. He told him to go home, and he said, as you go, don't sin any. Don't do any, don't commit wrong. Don't disobey, because that's sin. So Jesus had given him a marvelous word, and he heard him. I wonder if he remembered it when he got home. I'm sure he did. He said, go and sin no more. Let us stand, please. John, would you come and lead us in just as I am, please, without one plea. Thank you, Ann, for playing for us this morning. One of these days, David's going to help me to get some beautiful brass rails so that we can hold ourselves going up and down and not have the danger of falling.
Just as I am without one plea, but that thy blood was shed for me, and that thou bidst me come to thee, O Lamb of God, I come.
Do not have the victory in your heart, just feel free to come and pray as we sing the next stanza.
Just as I am and waiting not to rid my soul of one dark blot, to thee whose blood can cleanse each spot.
Sleeping at night in his cabin, when suddenly his room was filled with light and the Savior appeared. The Lord told the man he had work for him to do and showed this man a large rock out in front of his cabin. The Lord explained to this man that he was to push against this rock with all his might. That's what he told him to do. This man did day after day. For many years he toiled from sunup to sundown. His shoulders sat squarely against the cold, massive surface of the unmoving rock, pushing with all his might. Every night the man returned to his cabin, sore and worn out, feeling that his whole day had been spent in vain. Since the man was showing signs of discouragement, the adversary decided to enter the picture by placing thoughts in the man's mind. He was weary. You've been pushing against that rock for a long time and it hasn't budged. Why kill yourself over this? You're never going to move it, thus giving the man the impression that the task was impossible, that he was a failure. These thoughts discouraged and disheartened this man. Why kill myself over this, he thought. I'll just put in my time and give just the minimum of effort. That will be good enough. And that's what he planned to do until one day he decided to make a matter of prayer, and he took him and his troubled thoughts to the Lord. Lord, he said, I have labored long and hard in your service, putting all my strength.